We got both. It's me, Chari. Okay, listen. I just went to the Lush Boxing Day sale. We don't have Boxing Day in America, but you feel me? It's the after Christmas sale. So, everything was buy one, get one free of all the holiday products. So, people, it was pretty crazy, I'm not gonna lie. Like, when I got there, okay, the Lush that I went to, it opened at 10. I know some Lushes opened at 7, but the one closest to me opened at 10, so I went at 10. And I had to wait. There was a line outside the door. Sorry, people. My door is open for the light, but there's people in the backyard, so sorry about it. Okay, what was I saying? So I had to wait in line, and people, it was super windy today, okay? And I was just wearing this vintage cardigan and my Deadly Dames capris, which I'm not wearing anymore. I'm wearing leggings now because I was so cold. And it was so freaking windy, and like I thought my eyelashes were gonna like blow off. It was so windy and so cold, and I probably waited in the line. I feel like, honestly, it felt like an hour, but it was probably like 30 minutes. But they were only letting in like one or two people in at a time because it was too crazy. And yeah, so then I got in, and I thought that they were gonna be out of a lot of stuff just because, like, you know how we had to wait in a line to even get in? So I thought it was gonna be like really empty. The pre-wrapped gifts, the Christmas pre-wrapped gifts, were all sold out. The rose jam was all sold out. But thankfully, the other things that were like on my list were, I'll just show you, okay? But yeah, so I mean, other than that beginning part, oh, and then after, once we picked out everything we wanted, we had to give it to Lush employee, and then they put it in a shopping bag, and then I had to like go outside and wait in another line on the opposite direction to like line to pay, and that was another like 30 minutes. That was honestly, people, I mean, it wasn't that bad, just the fact that it was freaking windy and it was really cold, but that's probably why I said it was so crazy. There's also some crazy people too, but crazy people are everywhere. Okay, anyways, let's get into the haul, okay? Okay, so, yeah. Okay, so the first buy one, get one free was one of the things I've been like lusting after ever since I saw it on like my Facebook feed. It is the Christingle body conditioner, people. And if you watched, I don't know if it was a few hauls ago, I showed I had a little sample of it. I didn't even use the sample because honestly, they gave me a tiny little bit, and I thought, cool, that could go on my hand. So there's a dog right there. Anyways, so I was so afraid they were gonna run out of this, but they didn't. It's a body conditioner, so you put it on your body after you do your shower gel, and it's just like, honestly, people, those commercials that you see before YouTube videos about that Jergens wet skin moisturizer, people, Lush did it first, okay? Lush did it first, and Jergens is just trying to copy, make a cheap chemical version of what Lush made for like $2. When, anyways, this is not a rant video. Okay, so this one has spearmint and murmur butter and shea butter. So people, you guys know I love anything with murmur butter because that goes like deeper into your skin than any other kind of butter, you feel me? So this is what it looks like. And it smells, honestly, okay, it smells spearminty, but it also smells, I was gonna say very clean, but spearmint is a clean scent. I was gonna say kind of like fresh laundry. Like, even though it's like spearmint, it's supposed to be minty, also smells like clean laundry. But yeah, it says menthol crystals, peppermint oil, whatever, whatever. I'm just really excited. I got two of these things. So I bought, paid for this one, and I got another one for free. So, excited. Okay. Oh, and what I was going to say, why I wanted this so bad. Okay. Besides, you know, the great murmur butter, shea butter, you know. But for my muscles, people, you guys know, like, literally in almost every vlog, I'm always talking about how, like, I'm so sore, I'm so achy, and so I feel like this will really help. So I get to soothe my muscles and also have soft, moisturized skin too at the same time. So yeah, that's enough about Chris Tingle. Okay, then I got some bath bombs. People, you guys know one of my all-time favorite bath bombs is Lord of Misrule, and I got Lord of Misrule, so I got, that's what it looks like, and it's just, I just honestly can't even get over the smell. Like, it honestly, if, when I smell this, I don't smell patchouli. Like, I think I definitely smell the vanilla, but that, because I usually hate patchouli. If you watch my videos, you guys know I hate patchouli. But just the it's like a perfect combination, you know? Like, it's just like, I love it. So amazing. Lord of Misrule. Loves that. So I got another, I got two of these. So this one. And then I bought this, then the second one was free. So cool. And then I got another bath bomb, which you guys know I love, and I talked about before, and I shoved it in another haul. The Yognog bath bomb. And this one is scented exactly like the Yognog soap. And inside is actually a bath melt. So this is like a two-in-one kind of thing. And actually what I did last time when I bought this is I let it fizz in my bath until it was like I don't know, shrunk down to like maybe half the size that this is. And I just like took it out of my bath because it's a slow fizzer. So I just took it out of my bath and I just let it dry, and then I used it for a second bath. So you can do that if you want, for, you know, that's just my opinion. And I wanted to get a piece of Yognog soap because I love that soap, honestly. Not only because of the smell, but it's honestly, like, when you touch it, it's, like, so creamy. But anyways, but yeah, I didn't have enough money. And also, I didn't even check because I just knew. I was just like, I know this is going to be cutting close to my budget, so I didn't even check if they had. But anyways. And some Lush stores, people, listen, if you weren't able to go to a Lush store for the sale, and you know, if by the time you looked online all the stuff was sold out, like, some Lush locations still have Christmas items, like a few Christmas items, even like a week later, like, honestly. So I mean I would advise go to Lush as soon as possible, but you know, that's my thing about it. There might be a lot of stuff sold out, but you never know. So anyways, oh, okay, yeah, so then I got another Yognog. And then I got Lord of Misrule shower gel. My precious. Yeah, they had tons of Lord of Misrule. I didn't see any of the large size. This is the medium size. I saw a lot of the medium size. I saw a lot of baby ones, but yeah, they didn't have rose jam, or I think I did see snow fairy, but I'm not really sure because I don't really care about snow fairy shower gel. But yeah, and this one is scented just like the bath bomb, and is very softening on your skin, and it doesn't really make a lather when you use it, but. Yeah, it says Fair Trade Vanilla Absolute gives this earthy gel a sweet, comforting twist. I just, honestly, I want the perfume of this. Yes. Anyways, yeah, so then I got this, and I was going to get another Lord of Misrule shower gel, the same size, but I just didn't end up having, like, enough money, because I also got Bouche de Noël facial cleanser, and I originally was gonna get like two of each so I could get like buy one, get one free of each one, but it was just like way too close to my budget, you feel me? So I just put one back of each. So I bought this one and I got this one for free. So, and this one is the facial cleanser that has been coming out, I think, for the past 3 years. And it's essentially angels on bare skin, but with cranberries and with brandy in it. So it's just like an amped up version of angels on bare skin. So if you like angels on bare skin, you'll love Bouche de Noël. So yeah, and I really like this for like brightening your skin, especially like, you know, in the winter when your skin is like so like dry and dull and just like lackluster. This one helps, you know, remove any extra dead skin, but also like brightens it, feel me? So yeah, I was gonna say something else, but I forgot. Oh well. Okay, then, oh, and then this one, people, I wasn't even really like lusting after like I was for these other things, but I mean, I just saw it and I was like, I could probably use that. It's the peppermint bark body scrub, and it looks like this. At first, when I saw the display of it, I thought this was Rough with the Smooth, the one that scented like Lord of Misrule, which also has Murmur Butter in it. But that one is available year-round, and this one was limited edition. And I've been needing to buy a new scrub for, mostly I use these kind of solid scrubs for like my feet and my legs for, because of my sore muscles, you know, it just feels really good when I use, you know, more kind of intense exfoliation on my feet and my legs, because those are the muscles that are like always hurting me. But I thought this would be good for that, but also because it's made with peppermint, so that's like super like tingly and intense, you know, for my sore muscles. So and honestly, it does smell like peppermint bark. Like oh, I need to do a favorites, but I got this, one of my dancers gave me like a pound of peppermint bark, and it smells exactly like this. Like, it kind of smells chocolatey, kind of smells chocolatey too. Like, not, okay, listen to me, I'm not like the biggest fan of peppermint, the way it tastes, the way it smells, just because I feel like sometimes it's too like, too intense. But this, I think they did put, I don't know exactly the ingredients off the top of my head, but I think there is like cocoa butter in here, because it does smell a little bit chocolatey. So I'm excited to use this. Oh, and I bought two of these. So I bought one and I got one free. So, because most of the time these ones, these kind of solid body scrubs kind of go fast, just because like, well, it depends how much you use, but you know, it's not like in a pot like this. So it's not like, you feel me? I don't know, but yeah, I got two of these, and that's it. So I got all Christmas stuff. If you want me to go over prices here, so the most expensive thing was the Kris Tingle. It was $26.99. All right, Lord of Misrule bath bomb. Oh, Lord of Misrule shower gel was $21.95, and Yognog bath bomb $6.95. Lord of Misrule $6.95. Salt and peppermint bark, that's what it's called. That one was called, that was $9.95. And then, so I got Bouche de Noël free. Basically, people, let me just tell you what I saved, okay? Wait. I don't even know. Basically, I got Bouche de Noël free, which is usually like $15. See, this is why I never say prices in my videos, because it's boring and who cares, right? yeah, it doesn't say the price. It just says I got it for free. So, and then, you know, then I got this for free, two bath bombs for free, and the peppermint bark for free. So, wait, one, two, four, six. So I paid for four things and I actually got eight things. Right. Anyways, people, I'm very excited. The only thing I wish I could have gotten was the rose jam shower gel, but, and the Yognog soap, but I mean, hopefully it'll come back next year, and I've already experienced. I already bought the soap earlier this month, or last month, I think, and then the rose jam shower gel. I still have some from last year, so that's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Later, haters.